I'd love to see the insides of this spell. I can't abide housework. You are not a cockroach. Strange. Inundated with cockroaches, I am. Black ones, four limbs, nasty, spiky things. Are you spiky? If so, my ribbons will pluck your spines. Malachi liked spines. Liked my spine. Pretty spine. Bejeweled and bountiful. Enough to make an empire weep. Do you weep, not a cockroach? I do. Tears are infinite. Why, on this very day, I've found a new reason to cry. What is that you have? Not a cockroach? My ribbon spool. Those black ones wanted them, my ribbons. Wanted to wrap the city in black ribbons. Now they are my ribbons forevermore. Forevermore. I hate forever. I could tear happy ever after from bard's bleeding tongues. You're still here, not a cockroach. Oh, gratitude, yes. I should give you a token. Token? What token? This? Is this to your liking? The cockroaches will come again. They want the twist. That cockroach emperor. The other bugs shout his name. Ravisius. Cross the river, squash the emperor cockroach in his nest. The bridge? It is barricaded. That spawns a tricky question. Questions, questions. I asked too many questions. Chit has told me so. I asked where it all went, our feculence. He made them show me. Under the river, the sewers from this side to that. Filthy, fetid tunnels like a rower's cloaca. A black place, crawling with the undying. Once beautiful and arrogant gemlings, now the foul waste of the Empire. Fitting, isn't it? Apt. 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 I like you, not a cockroach. I like that you listen. It would annoy me if the Undying murdered you. Thormetic sulfite. That's what you need. A nasty, nasty substance it is. Melikai had his slaves mine it. Carry it from northern mountains to the refinery by the docks. Ezomites. Maraketh Karui. It killed them all, fevered the blood and scorched the mind. But you are clever, not a cockroach. You will keep it at arm's length. You will bring it to me so that I may make you something, an infernal talc that will bring furious light to undying darkness. I loved Melikai. He gave me gems, divine jewels for his gemling queen, for his dead queen. But I didn't want me dead. Melikai begged, for him, for the Empire. I chose me, selfish me. The Empire died, and I live. I live, and live, and live, and live. I was the Emperor's favorite for a time, but Chittus had many favorites. He filled the scepter of God with favorites. Every now and then, he cleared away the clutter. Those who pleased him, they were given to his lords and generals. Those who did not, were given to his thaumaturgists. I talked too much, asked too many difficult questions. I was gifted to Melikai. My dear, troubled Melikai. Leave me, not a cockroach. What? much clutter.
The Monkey King names you slave. No, you are the gems of Rayclast, not the treacherous stones you dig and die for. It is time to bend the Monkey King's ear. Tell him your true name.
Stay out of the shadows.
You have thormetic sulfite? You are a resourceful unbug now, aren't you? Give it to me.
I was all eyes and ears when Malachi worked. I know exactly what to do. A dash of arcanity, a pinch of insanity, a whisper of profanity, and the infernal talc is now ready. It's the most explosive of powders. A sprinkle, the gentlest of dustings of infernal talc will provoke gems to a molten rage. For the undying, the very sun will rise within their flesh. They will burn for their sins, not a cockroach. They will burn. Leave me, not a cockroach.
The Gemling Queen? She's impossible. How did she survive? Why is she not one of the undying? No. No, these questions can wait. There's a more pressing one. Is she safe from the Ebony Legion? You've been busy. With the spool back where it belongs, the Wiggins should be able to keep the Ebony Legion at bay. We've both seen what they can do to a man. Whether you were saving your own skin or thinking of others, it matters little to me. You succeeded where I did not. You have stood in the presence of the Gemling Queen. I can only hope to meet her in my nightmares. Piety's a genius, sculpting mere human clay into divine gemlings. At least, that's what she told me when she opened me up and buried a virtue gem in my entrails. Malachi did the same in the name of the Emperor centuries ago. Chittis' gemlings still rule, San. We call them the Undying now. Goodbye.
Hello. The blackguards talked about Piety's precious gems being infected with nightmare. Tolman, what did she do to you? You find a high enough spot and you can see the Lunaris Temple over the river, at the western edge of the city. Since the blackguards arrived, the clouds above that temple have been stained with the blackest of smoke. You can see it sometimes when the westerly blows. It stinks worse than death. On the fall of the Empire, the historians are deathly silent. After the Purity Rebellion, the Kingdom of Khal blockaded Orion, preventing any trade or correspondence with the mainland. It's said that Khal planned to invade. Only when the Karui retreated did Orion get any news from Rayclast. But by that time, there wasn't really anyone left to tell the tale. Chittis thought that the Gemling was the pinnacle of human progress. These glorious gems have brought us within spitting distance of godhood, he once said. The High Templar at the time, Vol of Febris, thought they were a perversion. He wanted the Empire made pure, cleansed of the stain of thaumaturgy. You look at San and tell me which one you think was right. And while you're out there, look out for monkeys. No, not those bloody monkeys from Freesia. These ones are painted on the walls. I think you'll find them enlightening. Be careful.
What is it? Citizens of San that was. The Undying have been around for hundreds of years. Left to their own devices, they're likely to survive for hundreds more. Still, they're not immune to mortality's touch. They can be killed with some difficulty. It's an often told story among the Karui, how Vol of Thebris bent his knee to my ancestor King Kong and promised freedom in return for war. While Vol raised his Purity Rebellion in heart of the Empire, Kaum took Lord Lion-Eye's head and the southern coast all the way to the Siren's Cove. It was the greatest conquest the Karui had ever seen. Be well.
What's going on?
Stay out of the shadows. They bite. Stay out of the shadows.
So there you are. Gems represent the one true power here in Rayclast. The Vaal understood this, the Eternals also. Now it is our turn to study and exploit these most precious of stones. Geomancy, I have come to call the field, and of one thing I am certain. It is we geomancers who shall inherit this fallen empire, who shall raise this realm to its former glory and beyond. I have much that I might impart to you on the subject, but whether you are worthy of such enlightenment, well, that remains to be seen.
Ask away.